Guess who's really sick, but is gonna do a review anyway, because I love Jojo. So here is this review of this episode, episode 11 of Jojo, whatever, Golden Wind, whatever you want to call it. So, this episode, well, Nara-chan, or however the freak you say his name, Nara, we got his backstory, and, he does not look good as a blonde, I'm gonna say that right now, just no, never go blonde, dude, never, ever, you look horrible. But his whole backstory was very interesting, and I felt bad for him, and losing his mom like he did, and then feeling like he got his mom's eye disease. I'm like, oh, you poor thing, no, that's not what's happening, you just got hit in the face, you're gonna be fine. But anyway, you know, we kind of learned his story and everything. It's like, okay, great, we know about you now. I legit thought he was gonna die. I'm like, this spider is literally injecting you with poison, venom, whatever, as we speak, and suddenly it just gets big, and then, like, it's fine, but I'm like, isn't the spider venom still in your veins? Like, what? I don't know, but it's Jojo, don't question it. So, after he, defeats that guy, I guess, I'm not sure if that guy's actually dead, or if he's gonna, like, get help. I think he's dead, but I don't really know, because I feel like he's somehow alive, and he's gonna get his friends to know about what's going on, and then he might die. I don't know. He might be dead. No idea. But, man, though, all the previous episodes that I didn't do reviews for, I have seen them, obviously, and I kind of hoped that Trish wouldn't be as bitchy as she was. I was like, oh, well, dang. But I'm hoping there's more to her, that she's not so bitchy, and why there, I don't know. But anyway, so after that, you know, he makes it back to the vineyard and everything, and they get a message from the boss saying, hey, there's this thing, there's this vehicle by this area, go find it. So Bruno sends Giorno, the orangish haired guy, and the other guy with, like, the whitish hair, I forgot his name, I forgot a lot of their names, because I haven't learned almost all their names yet, but he sends them off to go find the vehicle and everything. So they're doing a split thing. I'm assuming it's gonna be kind of a split story now, maybe, like, you know, we see Giorno's group, and then we see the other group, what's ever going on with them. So that's a thing. I probably sound really sick, but it's fine. I'm dying inside. But anyway, see what I mean? But anyway, yeah, that's pretty much all this episode there was. I have to say, though, that one scene with Giorno and the guy, when, like, he grabbed him by the chin, I'm like, dude, this is a little gay. We need to stop that. Everyone's like, this part of JoJo is super gay. And I'm like, I see what they mean now. I completely understand. Oh boy, so now to not kill myself, you know, from being sick and everything. That's really all I gotta say about this episode. Not too much to say, mostly because I'm sick and everything is painful, everything hurts. I wanna die, I can't even fall asleep, but it's fine. So, anyway, what did you guys think of this episode? What do you think is gonna happen next? And I'll see you guys. Oh, I did wanna say this thing though. The guy did mention that Trish might have a stand, and I'm like, I don't know, I don't think she does, but it'd be really cool if she did, I'm just saying. I'd really like that, but I'm doubtful. I don't think she does, but she might. It'd be pretty cool if she did, but who knows. So anyway, I'll see you guys whenever Let's Play review video I do next is, okay? Bye!